Everyone, Wolf here, and welcome to another Let's Talk About Books. So today we're going to talk about all of these. First of all, we're going to talk about the books I've read for my reading challenge. That's just these three. I am going to talk about them from worst to the best. So I'll start with this one. One Foot Wrong. Well, wrong is the right word to describe this book. I bought this book on some kind of a jumble sale. And the cover art is one of the first things that draws me in, if it's a book that I don't know anything about. And then on the back there was, One Foot Wrong will at times take your breath away. The darkest yet most poignant Alice in Wonderland imaginable. I am a huge fan of Alice in Wonderland, and yeah, I'm also a huge fan of things that have a dark vibe. I like horror stories and stuff like that. So this was the description I got from this book, and I thought, yes, this will be a wonderful book. But no, it wasn't, and it didn't have anything to do with Alice in Wonderland, so I don't know where this description comes from. This book is about Hester, which is a young girl who, yeah, for no apparent reason, is not allowed to go out of the house from her parents. Yeah, she seems to have a little bit of a mental illness, according to the parents. So, and yeah, they are like ashamed of it, that they have a child with that. And that's why Hester is not allowed to leave the house. Child Protective Services, well, I think it's those guys, get to know that she's there and that she's the right age to go to school. And then she goes to school and Hester starts, yeah, to think a little bit more of her own, and she starts to rebel against the things that her parents established as ground rules and stuff. So her parents start punishing her, and it's a really abusive way of punishing her, and her father even rapes her. Yeah, I really know those are horrible things, and I was really disgusted with reading those things. But then it even gets worse. Hester gets sent away to a mental institution, I would say, and at some given moment she wants to escape there to go back home. First of all, I was like, why on earth would you ever want to go back to that place? But she wanted to go back because she heard the house calling her and the stuff inside there, because she kind of talked with the things that were there. The things talked back to her, so I really think that's strange. That when she comes home, the ex tells her to take him with her and go to the room of her parents. She just murders her parents because the ex tells her to do it. She hangs her parents the way the way they hung her when she lived with them. And then she chops them into bits and boils them and eats them. And then the tree tells her to set fire to the house. And the whole book ends with her going back to the mental institution, and nobody ever knows that she did it or something like that. And then she gets to go home with one of her friends from the institution to her brother's house, and they live happily ever after. I know her parents were terrible people and that they did horrible things to her, but that does not justify her killing them in such a brutal way and not even getting punished for it. But yeah, that's my opinion. I really did like this book. Let me know in the comments down below if you've read this book, what you thought of it, but I really did like this one. So yeah, I finished reading it, because I always finish reading my books even if I don't like them. Then the second one I'm going to talk about is Extremely Loud and Incredibly Close. This one I really did like. However, it was in my reading challenge before I started the school year, but I was planning on reading it in March, but I had to speed that one up because it has an assignment in my course before December, So I mixed pleasure with business a little bit with this book. And this book is about Oscar, who loses his dad in 9/11. And the thing is, he finds a key in his father's dressing room, and that key has the name Black written on the envelope in which it was found. And Oscar starts a whole quest to find the person to which the key belongs to. And in between his quest, you get to know a little bit of how his grandmother and his grandfather are from Dresden in Germany, where a really huge bombing took place at the end of World War II. And yeah, I don't know if I mentioned it before, but I'm kind of a history buff when it comes to the World Wars, so I really liked reading those parts, and I think that's the biggest way they differ from, well, that the book differs from its movie, because there's a bigger focus on how the grandparents met and how his grandfather is traumatized by the events that happened then. And yes, that really made this book for me. And I don't know what you would think about stuff like that, but that would make a book great for me. Especially when it's a book that is based on true events. It is said that these are fictional characters, but the events that they describe, we all know that they happen. So it made the book more interesting that way. So I really recommend this book. I don't know about you. Let me know in the comments down below what you thought of this book. Then the third book is my absolute favorite right now. A Clockwork Angel from Cassandra Clare. It's the first book that I read from Cassandra Clare, and it's the first book in the Infernal Devices series, which is not the first series from the Shadowhunters that has been published, but if you look at it chronologically, it is the first, yeah, book that happens actually. Right, in this book you get to meet Tessa Gray and Jem, and it has already been a while since I've read this one. It's not on here. William. And Tessa thinks she's a mundane, but she moves to Victorian London because her brother asked her to. And when she gets captured by some sort of witches, she learns about her powers of shapeshifting, which means that she's not a mundane, but she also doesn't really know what she is. She gets to meet the Shadowhunters in the London Institute, and together they fight against a whole clockwork army that is made by the boss of Tessa's brother. Let me rephrase that. Which is made by the boss of Tessa's brother. Yeah, it gets a bit complicated. But the way this book is written and the whole story actually really drew me in, and I just couldn't put it down. As soon as I stopped reading this book, I started researching the other Shadowhunter book, and I started watching the series and the movies. Well, the movie singular. And the thing is, yeah, the series is a little bit High School Musical version of what the vibe is that I got from this book. And yeah, it is from the other series. It's from Mortal Instruments instead of the Infernal Devices. But the basic story of this really drew me in, and I'm really planning on buying the rest of the Shadowhunter book, starting with the Infernal Devices, because they are a lot. Okay, so my camera fell out for a little while. So this book is my favorite for now, and I really would like to read the rest of the Shadowhunter books. But that will be for after my reading challenge, and I will only start with the Infernal Devices because there are way too much Shadowhunter books right now, and yeah, you have to start somewhere, I think. If I finish that series, that I will see about the rest. Right now, with everything that I know of the Shadowhunters, my favorite character is Magnus Bane But I think his role is more important in the Mortal Instruments series. So maybe that will weaken a little bit if I read the rest of the Infernal Devices. Those are all the books from my reading challenge that I've read for now. I've read another book, but it's a small book. In the meantime, this one, 12 Angry Men. It is a play for those who do not know it. It's a play about 12 jurors who are picked to decide the fate of a young boy who seemed to have murdered his father. That's also one of the books that I had to read for my school. And, well, yeah, together with Extremely Loud and Incredibly Close, those were the two I had to read for my school. And I liked the play because it was about crime, and I like reading books and watching series and movies that have a crime element in there. The thing is, would I convict the murderer, the boy who is on trial for murder? Well, I have reasonable doubt after reading this play, so I wouldn't convict him. I do not say he's innocent, but the investigation needs to be retaken. Then the book that I'm reading right now for my reading challenge, this one, Grimalkin Manor. It doesn't seem to be such a good book as A Clockwork Angel or Extremely Loud and Incredibly Close, but it is better than One Foot Wrong. It is about a group of ghost hunters who go into an haunted mansion in England, and about them trying to prove if there is a ghost or not. Right now, it's really more about the feelings between the characters and the dynamic in the group. So it's not like let me rephrase. This book is not what I expected it to be. I expected the paranormal part would be bigger, and I thought, yes, nice horror book to read, but it doesn't really turn out that way for now. I'm almost halfway there. Maybe it changes, but yeah, no. For now, it's not really what I expected it to be, and yes, hope it gets better. But I'm going to finish it, as I always do. Then, the last book I'm going to talk about is my newest book that arrived last Friday, and you've already seen that we went to see the film about this one. We uploaded that video last week. Right now, I have the screenplay. The thing about these books is, and that was the same with the last screenplay of Fantastic Beasts, these have a wonderful cover art. And if you look inside, it doesn't. The beautiful art is not only on the outside, it's also on the inside. It's really. Those are really beautiful books, really worth collecting them. And yeah, like I said, it is a screenplay for those who do not know these. So, if you've seen the movie, you actually know what's in this book. I am going to read it though, but it is exactly what happens in the film. But I really do like the cover art. That's really. And actually, if you do not like rewatching the movie 100 times, but there are some details that you forgot, just look it up in the screenplay. And then you'll find it. Well, then you can read it in your own time and in your own way and can remember it better. So, this is a really beautiful book, and I know I will like the contents because I like the movie. Those were all the books that I was planning on talking about. So, I'll try to show you all of them. So, here they are. And that was Let's Talk About Books for this week. See you. Probably next week. Bye! Oh, before I forget, happy Thanksgiving to all our American viewers. Bye!